battle cry, the march of the drum calling me from my slumber, pushing me toward new day.
3.5 million copies and gave us a chance to tour the world. We were all incredibly excited about this time in our lives, and we decided to make a film about the next album, but it quickly turned in.
Kings and Queens.
One.
Into the night, desperate and broken, the sound of a fight. Father has spoken.
Definitely something in there.
Let's try it again.
I think this is the part.
I think so too.
It's too. I'm sitting here. I'm singing it in my head. It's infectious. I want to hear it again.
That guitar creeping up.
Great.
Yeah.
So I know from making records like this, the hard work, the struggle, is all part of it. It's about being truthful to yourselves. That's what I mean about now. It's like, you can take it and embrace it and go with it. Be a bit off balance, try out a few mad things, and now you're in a great place to do that.
This, we got some good news. We were nominated for a Latin MTV award, so we packed our bags and flew ourselves to Mexico. After an exciting and unforgettable night, we woke up to discover that we had been served with legal papers from EMI.
Okay, one.
What a bad beginning on that. And again. Get warmed up, dude. One more. Perfect. Let's just do a couple more and then we'll listen. One more. One last one. Uno más. Give me 1 second. I'm gonna loosen my hand up. One more. Just for fun.
Dude, you're still under 100 takes. You're at 97.
It's 97? Okay, well, fuck that. We gotta do 3 more.
Yeah, come on.
Hold on, let me get ready.
Never been anyone as driven who will work as hard, who will go to the, you know, end of the earth and back, just on a 1 in a million chance that something's going to help their music.
There's nobody that I know personally that can say that they do for their art and their work what he does. You asked me what Jared's role is in the making of This Is War. It's too small of a question to encompass what he does in the world of 30 Seconds to Mars. He's the mastermind.
Success on the level that we even have right now, we never dreamed. How could you dream of this?
My brother and I were born in Louisiana.
Yeah, I like that. It sounds great.
I was just thinking, what should I play during that bridge?
It's definitely a place to play something different, I think.
What are the vocals doing? Right away, do they go off?
No, I'm not there yet.
Wait, what? I don't even know the chorus.
Day, maybe we'll meet again. No, no, no. Ever again. No, no.
It's also no rush. We should just take the time it needs to get it right. And if we have to do it over 3 days, we'll do it over 3 days.
Okay, I'm just in it. I just, yeah. You know, and then it's gone. I'm like, oh, okay.
No, I know how it is. I know how it is.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's all my
let's, encourage each other to enjoy it as well, to yeah. discover it, because there's awesome stuff. The fill that you came out with the snare,
yeah.
totally cool, and you've never done it before.
Celebrate later.
Have a little yeah. bit of joy while we do it.
Yeah,
too.
It's all good.
Play punch on the bridge.
Different processes, man. I am enjoying it. Got them all fooled.
We're getting there, but there's still lots to do.
I've never heard of a label.
It's really cool.
This is taiko drumming, and I'm learning about taiko drumming.
Shannon is a beast of a player.
He doesn't play on a song, he takes a song over. He inhabits it, he lives it, he breathes it.
There's an energy that he has when he drums that's fantastic. He's very animalistic.
He's completely emotionally reacting. It's absolutely fascinating to watch somebody like that.
What's the BPM? Go. Last chorus. Thank you very much. Have a nice fucking day.
La nuit du chasseur.
Take care of the lawsuit. That's already cost me more money than I have, than we have
right.
as a band. We have spent more money than we have in the bank.
Right. No, I understand.
I'm gonna have to tell them they can suck my fucking proverbial dick.
So in a sense, EMI's already bankrupt us. Kempler really is controlling this?
No. The money guys are controlling it. You know, Terra Firma.
Look, fuck them. That's such bullshit. How could that motherfucking would sit there and tell us that he was going to do something and then not do it. Across the pond, it's Guy Hans. And here in America, it's Jeff Kempler. And I think that he's either trying to show off for Guy Hans, and he thinks that he's going to stranglehold us. We have other options.
I myself, I'm ready to go all the way.
They're acting like they're so ready and happy and willing to just go into litigation that I'm having to prepare the battle plans.
I think everyone's getting lost in the deal and not seeing what a benefit it probably could be to me and to them for us to work out something fair and reasonable. But I just can't do it if it's not fair. I can't do it and feel like I'm being taken advantage of.
Okay, so what's the next move here?
We need you again.
Okay.
So, I don't know if you want to.
I thought this was going to be an easy song.
Yeah.
I actually didn't think it was going to be easy. I knew it was going to be a pain in the fucking ass. Can we try just doing that? Sure.
It's pretty fast.
Is it better 1 foot or two?
One, I think.
So weird, they're so fast. It's very awkward. Jesus Christ.
I don't know what you want, man.
We need power. We need power. It's not enough in one hand.
I got it, brother.
Yeah.
My brother. Ready?
This. We'll call you in a minute.
I don't know. I have no idea.
No, there's way too much inconsistency with the velocity going up and down too much on the hits.
Yeah, I'm humans, I know.
And that's why I'm trying to get you to do kind of so it can be more consistent.
I mean, the reality is
we haven't practiced it.
Right.
If you practice it for a few days, I bet you could do it.
Okay.
We may need to move on to a different song and have you practice this a little bit every day, and then we come back and play it 2 weeks, 3 weeks from now. Because you're just not flowing. No more.
Yeah, I'm doing what I can do, man.
Well, think of a different beat. We got to record the song. We can throw the song out, or we can try
to... This is the beat, though. What do you want me to do?
I can't sing it right now. You couldn't pay me all the money in the world to sing this song the way it needs to be sung right now. I'm not ready. Can you put it on the big speakers and turn it up for a second? Hey, what about a little bit of like...
Maybe the children of a lesser god between heaven and hell. Heaven and hell. There's nothing like starting your new year in a swamp.
This is at Frank Lloyd Wright House. I thought it would be a great place for us to record and would be really inspiring. You know what's exciting? We're gonna have the spirit of this house inside the record.
It's a sort of living, breathing piece of art.
Right in here.
Choose your weapon carefully.
Art, it's something that we all aspire our work to be.
Some people can do whatever they think of, and what they think of is special and moves other people. Those people are artists.
It's their bare, honest truth about something that they love.
I think it's one of the avenues to get to oneself, to find out who we are.
Timeless art is the most difficult form of art. I see it in the Chrysler Building. I see it in the Concorde. I hear it in the Beatles. The business is...
On the piano. I'll do it right now, just for fun. Look. That's not yours. Not mine. No, it's just ludicrous.
Selling recorded music. That's the record.
After we rejected their last offer, EMI finally agreed to sit down face to face so that we could try and work something out. So I got on a plane and headed to New York.
Oh, I like that. It was fun.
Totally like that.
Did you record that?
The regular one.
Huh? No, I liked the beginning how you just played that.
Yeah. It's fucking with me because it's off. It gets off.
You just gotta listen to the click. You're good.
Hold on a second.
It's fine. You just gotta keep on that beat. That's the thing.
I'm playing to the click. It's
no, I know, but you're right with the click, so it's really hard. You know, you gotta be like a machine. Oh, humans.
Okay, you hear that the slicer's not with the click, right?
You want to play that?
Yeah, go ahead. Hey, go ahead. Yeah, please do. Prove me that the slicer's not slowing down.
Prove it right now. Where's my goddamn pick? Yeah, so do use his pull off and use my.
Okay. I mean,
other
we got
thing.
It in there. That's like the performances between the two are good enough. So.
Oh yeah!
Yeah, the elbow, baby! The fucking elbow! Wow! Rip it down, motherfucker! Yeah! Whoa, that was weak! Wow!
All along, EMI had been it.
There was truth, there was consequence against you. Just a weak defense, then there's me. I'm 17.
So Shannon, Tomo, and I got together and debated and discussed and made a decision. EMI came to us and offered us the deal we were fighting for. So we accepted.
Is it really Friday the 13th?
It is pretty brave, bold, and stupid of them to actually make a deal with a band, even if it's us, without having heard the record. But at the same time, they knew there's not a chance in fucking hell I was gonna play them a single second of this record. You have to do what's best for the music at this point. I think what's best for the music is re-signing with the EMI and putting a record out.
Goal on this album is to have as many people as possible find out about it so you can set up your career. It's all about the career.
So what do you think we should do?
Well, I think you should sign this thing, get your record out there, and get back to your career and away from courts.
What do you think we should do?
You should absolutely sign this deal right now and then go back to your studio and keep working.
Yeah. It's amazing that at the same time we're trying to make a deal, the world's falling apart.
Look, you've got 7 or 8 years of the record business just going straight in the dumper. And then 6 or 8 months ago, the rest of the world went with the record business. It's everything's in the dumper now.
So why don't I feel like we should be celebrating?
Because it's the record business. There's really nothing to celebrate about in the record right. business because it's a dying business. And especially on an international level where you guys are going to sell 70% of your records because more records still sell overseas, you know, you got to have one of these. Guys, and this is the one that you get without a lawsuit.
Jared, you were very idealistic and you wanted to right the wrongs of the record business, and you're not going to have your chance to be in court and to shine a light on the corruption of the music business and to take it down, but it's going down anyway. That's the problem.
It's hard to stop fighting. Sometimes.
Much tougher.
How do you stop fighting? No. How do you do that?
Because they're all fired.
This, by the way, is one contract. Take a deep breath, man.
The deal that we made was a very favorable one and a much better deal than 30 Seconds to Mars had.
The goal of the litigation is to accomplish whatever goal you've gotten to the litigation for. I don't think that the courtroom is a really good place for artists to be. I think they're better off in the studios.
The real battle is the clock starts. You got to finish the record.
Yeah.
Time to get this show on the road. No more excuses. Are you finished with this song yet?
So the new contract with EMI says that we have 3 weeks left to finish. The clock is ticking. Is there any kind of methodology that you know about to increase the productivity of the remaining days we have here?
So Guy Hand stepped down today.
Oh, did he?
That definitely means there's some shit shifting and changing around.
Breaking news.
The truth, not the moment to lie, the moment to live, not the moment to die, the moment to fight, 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 the moment to fight, to fight, to fight, to fight.
You know what I think?
What?
I think we're gonna finish the song tonight.
It's the moment of truth and the moment to lie and the moment to live and the moment to die. The moment to fight, the moment to fight, to fight, to fight.
Ah!
Pretty good one, pretty good one.
This one's real good.
Let's call it finished.
Woo! High five, yeah! Woo! Woo! Come on, don't leave me hanging, boy! Ah!
Yeah.
The future of the music business is unknown. That's what makes it exciting to some and really scary to others.